What things really make you cringe? When I remember that I did that, I do have a boyfriend. He just goes to another school thing. Secondhand embarrassment. It makes me physically ill. Someone obviously showing off at doing something when they are not that good at it really gets to me. The worst is when someone is singing along to a song. But instead of just vibing and singing for their own pleasure, they are looking around to make sure that other people are watching them sing. It's the worst. Just to be clear, doing something badly just because you enjoy it is encouraged and celebrated. You should see me on a dance floor. It's like an epileptic octopus. It's when the person doing it thinks they are good at it and has that smugness or attitude and is doing it for praise from other people. But they are not actually good at that thing. Watching the auditions for X Factor makes me feel sick. Those videos of guys trying really hard to be sexy, biting their lips and looking down and brushing their hair back. They make me cringe so hard. People who post vague status updates on social media, such as "the most horrible thing just happened to me," without providing any context. It's a cheap way for people to fish for attention, and it creates unnecessary worry for the people who care about them. YouTube comment threads that are essentially an endless string of "who else is listening in 2020? Any story about someone having a birthday party and no one shows up. It happened to my little brother when we were kids and I've been scarred from it since. People dying slash abuse slash grief slash loss slash horror etc. does not elicit the same emotional upset I get when I hear those kind of birthday stories. Thanks for the gold, kind stranger, just send a PM to the Gilder and stop ruining good posts. When people post selfies of them crying. No joke. My friend's sister posted crying selfies of her and her kids when they had their dog put to sleep. With the dead dog. Like. That's a private moment of grief, not a selfie opportunity. People who talk about "oh, I'm so ugly" when they are literally the most attractive person in the room, clearly just so people would compliment them. This doesn't go for looks only, but for skills too. When people film themselves doing something really generous and heartfelt for someone in dire need, e.g. a homeless person, mate, give them the money or the food or whatever, and get on with your life. I cringe at how that person must feel to have a camera or phone shoved in their face while they're accepting someone's shallow charity. I'm glad the person in need benefits, but I can't bear to watch them saying something in a group and getting dead silence afterwards. Also thinking about the stupid things I've done in past social situations. Also waving back at someone who wasn't waving at you. Also my voice, also having an idea of what to say in my head, but when I speak it just sounds a mess. Having to stick your hand into the nasty food water that has been sitting in the sink for several days to open the drain, and when you remove your hand the pieces of fish and lettuce and dark matter that are stuck to it. Folks who read motivational literature and then brag about what outstanding knowledge it contains. When I'm getting my hair cut and the clippers get near my right ear, the entire right side of my head gets extremely tingly and my back reflexively cringes away. It's like ASMR on super steroids. My dad had to get a shot in his eyeball the other day. He was telling me about it over the phone. I'm cringing now just rethinking about it. People shooting down ideas when they've asked for help. It angers me, but it also just really makes me uncomfortable. The time I thought I was being mature about sexuality and kept trying to tell my friends that they shouldn't be afraid of masturbation. That everyone does it. And girls do it too. Hey everyone, let's all tell our masturbation stories. I was 13 at the time. Oh god. And now I remember the time I somehow managed to bring using saliva as lube for masturbating during a ducking conversation. Why did you make me remember all this? Please end me like I ended my social status in school. People who always post slash talk about smoking pot. You smoke, that's cool. I used to, but Jesus, if drugs are your personality you might have a problem. Also TikTok cringe compilations. It's hard to find a good cringe compilation, but the TikTok ones are so hard to watch. TikTok. Fortnite dances. Dueling. Etc. Listening to someone speak passionately about something that no one around them has any interest in learning about. People who overshare for attention on social media, mainly Instagram. I can't stand someone just talking about themselves to a camera like the entire world /needs/ to know what they are doing every minute of the day. In a drama performance, I had to blow a kiss into the crowd and accidentally did it to a teacher to by accident, and following up I did the call me hand gestures. Guilt tripping. I've been around /survived too many narcissists to allow it. Related. Having to witness people continue to fall for narcissistic behavior. Not being able to explain that this perfect friend of yours is actually just a master manipulator. Oh. And mega Karens. When a decent looking girl posts a pic on Instagram. Read the comments. I can't look away. But it is a cringe factor of 10 every time. I have /such/ mixed feelings about young LGBTQ and teens who act like their sexual orientation is 87% of their identity. Wear rainbow clothes and rainbow makeup all the time. Etc. I'm glad they feel confident and proud, and it's kind of a part of growing up. But it's also such a small fraction of who they are /who they'll be in some of those outfits. Slogans. And memes are so cringy and awkward. Safe spaces. Our PE culture. 80 plus genders, etc. Pretty much anything the left throws at us, the normal people. Oh, and getting offended by everything. When people ask me if I speak Mexican, it always makes me cringe. I want to hit them back with, do you speak United States of America? The noise it makes when people who are congested don't blow their nose and instead suck the phlegm through their sinuses. The Tiger King, I tried to watch it last night, got through one episode and thought this is the definition of cringe. When you're eating steak or anything that requires a knife or fork and the tips of your fork or knife scrape across your plate and make that screeching noise. I'm still a kid. So I see stuff like this a lot. It's like when 4th and 5th graders are wearing crop tops and really trying to act older and sexualize themselves. LOL, and they try to pick fights too. It's so cringy I can't act. Bro, you're like 10, chill out. Parents posting fake quotes of their kids saying super woke things that a kid would never realistically say at that age. Litter on the ground when the trash can is right next to the item. Like, how the hell did you not throw away the trash properly? Phony acting in commercials or poor quality. Local commercials really make me grind my teeth and moan in frustration. People that can't accept other people's beliefs and choices but preach about how freedom is so sacred. All the incredibly dangerous disinformation and rewriting of history that is happening right now surrounding the global pandemic. And much of it is starting directly with leaders of various countries. It's truly despicable. And causing people who believe this false information to make dangerous and in many cases, lethal decisions about their own well-being during quarantine. I watch Jeopardy. A lot. The show is very tame and the contestants are usually professional and discreet. Sometimes the contestant comes on and argues answers and makes weird facial expressions. They may also look into the crowd in shock at answering incorrectly. It makes me cringe because the show is either you know it or not. There is no excuses. You're making $200 to $2,000 per each correct question. So yes, the standards are a bit higher. Those YouTube videos of people doing pranks in public or in stores. Those people put others around them in an uncomfortable position. And then post them online for everyone to see. Just writing this makes me cringe. Whenever the OK Boomer trend is mentioned, it was OK at first, but now it should go perish along with all the other trends taken too far. People who say they are influencers just because they have larger than average amount of Instagram followers.